Hey guys, so for today's video, I'm going to be showing some before and after of a few of my favorite images. I'm just going to be showing you guys what it looked straight out of the camera and then what it looked after post-production, so after I'd taken it through Lightroom and Photoshop. I do use both programs. I used to do all my color grading and everything in Lightroom and then take it into Photoshop to be frequently separated or skin retouched, but lately I've been sort of doing the opposite, where I'll take it into Photoshop first and do all my color grading there because I find that it's where I get more natural skin tones and the images look more professional that way. I do like the Lightroom editing setup, but I need layers. I'm a big layers person. So I'll take you through what I've done on each image. I don't know how many I'm going to go through, hopefully not too many, but we'll see. Alright, so I'm just going to jump right into that. Here's the before raw image. It's another studio shot. This model is Jasmine Aurora. I'll provide her Instagram handling as well. And then so here I'll show you what I did. This one is a more recent edit, so I've stopped editing and color grading in Lightroom, and I've begun doing all of that in Photoshop after frequent separation instead of doing color grading then frequent separation. So the first thing I do is I do the frequent separation. I do one to get rid of any acne and any skin bumps, and then I do another one to even the skin tones out, because I feel that just having one frequent separation folder doesn't cut it. It's easier for me to do two. The first one is when you do the Gaussian blur layer, you do it a little bit less blurred, so it picks up also a little bit of the texture when you're using your clone or stamp tool or whatever you use. And then for the second one, you blur it a little bit more, so you're picking up mainly just the colors and not very much texture. Then for another layer, I'll do a blank layer and use the brush tool, normally at like one opacity, and I'll grab some of the skin tones, just like Alt and select a skin tone, and then brush to sort of even it out. See how I toned down the highlights and made it like more of a smooth transition between the colors. And then the adjustment layer, I can't remember, there's what all I did in this one. I think it was mainly just to keep the skin natural and bring out a little bit of the pinks and stuff. I love pink tones. If you haven't seen my Instagram, there's quite a lot of pinky tone images. But yeah, this just brings out a little bit of the contrast and the colors of our skin, keeping it natural but adding some more like fun tones. Then in a saturation layer, just to add more pink to the lips and on the eyeshadow that I did. And that was this one. So for this edit, this was my first time actually working with an agency. So I contacted Jaeger Management. I do believe that's what they're called. Yeah, Jaeger Model Management, and asked if I could work with one of their models for the Creators Magazine here in Victoria for their very first issue. So this is model Ava. I called the shoot Forest Hydra because we used a lot of hydrangeas and then some dollar store like gold leafing for the makeup, just to make it a little more editorial, a little more edgy. And then, so this is the before, this is straight out of the camera. Okay, so here we have this is another one of my recent ones where I do all the work in Photoshop and then take it back into Lightroom and add just a little bit of clarity and sharpening, just because I really like the clarity tool, so I like to finish editing my images and then add a little bit more. I don't think that Photoshop has a setting that's similar to it, and it's just really easy and quick to use. So for this one, since Ava has such nice skin, the only really things are there were like two or three blemishes and just some leftover eyelash glue from having some of the other hydrangea flowers glued to her face earlier during the shoot. So frequent separation, just clear that right up. Keeping this nice highlight glow right here, I love highlight. I use probably way too much highlight powder or highlight when I do makeup just because I love the glossy looks. And then for the adjustments, just really brought out that that highlight and darken the contour. I neutralized a lot of the colors, making it quite a bit less saturated, a little colder tones. And then I really liked her hair color, but I wanted it to be a little bit more gray for this shoot. So I took away some of that saturation and made it a little more silvery than it was. Then added some saturation to the makeup, her lips a little bit, the flower, her eyes, and this flower, because I felt like it was pretty dull after I had taken away most of the saturation. And then dodge and burn last but not least, just to kind of even it out and give her more of like a, even more of a sculpted face. Actually, it looks like I took away. No, I added quite a bit of sculpting. Mainly, I like to lighten the eyes up just so they pop a little bit more, distinct the lips, and just accentuate that highlight and contour a little bit more, even out, make sure that her skin tones are nice and even. Again, Ava had really nice skin, so it was very easy editing her images. Okay, so for this image, this is even back before, or this was back again when I did all of the adjustments in Lightroom and then took it over to Photoshop just to be skin retouched. So here's the before straight out of the camera. This is model Amara, and we did an editorial called Heartstrings together, where we used a lot of just string that I had lying around my place to make these really cool makeup looks throughout the shoot. And so here's the raw, and here's after editing. As you can see, I brought up the highlights a little bit, added some blue and pinks into the shadows, and kind of just toned down the saturation just a tiny bit, and then took it into Photoshop, and here it is again. So this is back when I thought I was smart, and I would just copy this layer, Command J on, since I use Mac, and use a stamp tool, and then really, really tiny, and then go and get rid of all these little problem areas. A lot of this was just eyelash glue that was on her face from previous looks throughout the shoot. So I thought I was smart, but I was clearly not, because this image probably took me 2.5 hours to edit, because it was just a really slow process and you had to be very careful. Then next I would again copy this layer, use gouge and blur, and then use a black mask with a light flow of a white brush to bring out some of that underneath layer, just to soften up the skin textures just slightly. Then makeup and saturation, just to bring back some of these colors that I'd taken away when I'm editing. Then use dodge and burn to smoothen out and make these more of a nice gradient. Obviously it's not as good as what I do now with my editing techniques, but it worked. It was very time consuming, and I really love this image, but I do not recommend this, because like I said, this took me probably 2.5 hours to edit, and now editing images like this would probably take me maybe an hour, especially since she had really nice skin. There was just these few things from the makeup that needed to go. So for the last image, I'm going to do one of my favorites that I've taken of one of my friends, Kate. I absolutely love this image. I love the highlight and the shadows on her face, just her expression, the colors, and everything. I'm a big fan of my brown background and neutral colored studio shoots. I don't really like shooting on white backgrounds too much. I feel that it's just too bright. So this is one of the first images that I started using my new frequent separation technique in. So I did nothing really in Photoshop or Lightroom, and then took it into Photoshop to be edited. So here it is again, the raw straight out of camera. Then after frequent separation, you see that it's so much smoother than that last image, even on her arm, neck, just everywhere is a lot smoother. And this probably took me like 30 minutes maybe to do, probably closer to 20, which the other way would have taken me at least an hour. So I'm really happy with how this turned out. She obviously has incredibly nice skin, so it wasn't very hard, dodge and burn just to fix a little things I couldn't get in frequent separation. Then adjustments, I popped this highlight out, made the background a little more pink, brought out all the pinks in the image, the red, because she had so much pink, she had eyeshadow, the sunglasses, the lips, the bubblegum, the nails, and the dress she was wearing. Like I said, I really like pink tones for images. Oh yeah, I did this too. That's weird. It's been a while since I've edited this image, so I'm not exactly sure what all is in that adjustments layer. Then I brought out some lip contrast, just made a curves layer and black mask and put it on her lips to brighten them up to sort of match the sunglasses a little bit. And then sort of did the same thing with the sunglasses to make them a little more pink and brighter. And then that was it for this one. I'll provide before and afters at the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to hit subscribe if you want to keep seeing videos.